Let's today create this simple profit and loss analysis template, which you can use every month to track your profit, loss, costs, revenues, and create this beautiful dashboard. So let's open up a new sheet, and first of all, let's track all the revenues. Let me call this first tab as revenue. Let me just put a heading saying revenue for the month of so and so. And now here I put the details like serial number, project, revenue. Let me just list down some dummy data over here. And then I'll do a total of this particular revenue. And this is going to be my total revenue for the month. The next thing that I want to do is to list down all the costs that I have incurred. Let me put down all the costs in a separate tab. It would be easier to track it that way. So I'll just open up a new tab and call it costs. And then I'll put costs for the month. Here I can have cost head and the cost. You can just list down all the costs that you incur over here, like salaries, rental or lease. Then you could have licenses, electricity, internet, and then the other different costs as well. Now, if you have further details to any of the costs head, you can create a separate table. Like salaries, you could put down the individual salaries of each and every person over here in a separate table here. Like I could call it employee name or ID and then the salary. Employee 1, employee 2, employee 3, employee 4, and then I can put the numbers for the salary. Something like this. And then salaries, it will be just a sum of all the different salaries that have been mentioned over here. Similarly, you can have further details for licenses that you use and create a separate table here. A sum of all of these cost heads should give you the total cost for the month. Next thing that you can add over here is the capital expense amortization. So normally when you start a business or if you have done some capital expense in your business, you do not directly add it to the cost of one particular month. You take an amortization period and say that, okay, my particular asset is going to be amortized in these many months. And then for that period of time, you take the delta cost every month into your total cost. Let's just take a simple example here. Let me call this sheet as capital expense, capex details. And let's say this table here is actually my capital expense that I've done some time back. And this is the total amount that I spent in capital expense. Now, what I need to mention over here is the amortization period. Let's say I want to amortize these assets in 36 months. So for 36 months, I will need to add a particular amount to my cost, which would be equal to the grand total divided by these many months. So this is going to be my per month cost. And then here, let me also add what would be the last month for my amortization. So let's say it's March of 2022. Now, if I'm using this particular sheet as a template, I'll know that March 22 is the last month when I need to add this to my cost. So I'll go to the cost tab again, and here let me say one cost is capital expense. I'll make it equal to this particular cost. All right, now that you have all the different things in place, which is the revenue, cost, and capital expense, the last thing is to create a dashboard. So the first thing that you'll need is total revenue, which will be simply equal to this number, then total cost, which is going to be equal to the total cost in the cost tab, which is this one. Your profit is going to be revenue minus the cost, and profit percentage is going to be equal to profit divided by the total revenue. Now, what you can also do is that you can create various charts for graphical representation of this particular data. Let's say you want the revenue versus cost analysis. In that case, just select these two headers and the numbers over here, and then go to insert, recommended charts, and let's say we take this particular chart over here. After that, let's say another chart that you want is the cost analysis. What are the different cost heads that I have? We'll just go to the cost tab, select all the cost heads like this, and then go to insert. Let's take a pie chart and insert a pie chart, something like this. What you can also do is that just cut this chart from the tab, go to dashboard and paste it over here. And let's say the third kind of chart that you want is the revenue spread across various clients. Then you simply need to go to the revenue tab, select the project and the revenue like this, insert. And let's say you want this particular chart, a bar chart, and do like this. Here you get the chart, cut it from the tab and paste it in the dashboard. Something like this. Now once you're done with the data, then you can apply formats to your different tabs as well as the charts, and your dashboard will look something like this. This is the tab for your revenues, this one for your costs, and as I said that you can have different granular details for each cost head over here, then the capital expense details and the dashboard. Believe me, it will not take you more than 10 minutes to create this particular template. But if you still want, a link to download this template is available in the description. You can just download it and start using it. Are you interested in watching more videos on task trackers and dashboards? Just click on the link that's showing up on your screen. And until next time, bye-bye.